What's up, YouTube? So before we get started with this video, on first take, they're going to be talking to the Golden State Warriors, Andre Iguodala, and he's going to make comments about how a lot of times Steph Curry receives a lot of hate. So let's see what they have to say about that.
Is the dynasty over? That is the Golden State Warriors. And B, do you think KD is going to end up staying or going?
Well, I hope KD stays, you know, but it's a decision that I think he's making the right, you know, he has the right mindset as far as, you know, he's going to do it himself. He's going to take the time to, you know, not have any outside influences. He understands where he wants to be in life in basketball as the best basketball player on the planet right now. I think you saw him come back for, you know, that 6 or 7 minutes. He came back in game five, and you saw it was like it's not even close how incredible this guy is. But he knows, you know, what we've been able to build. And we'll always be brothers, regardless if he goes somewhere else or he stays. Of course, we want him back. And he knows that. But going into next year, we're going to be confident again. You know, you saw what Draymond did the second half of the season, getting his body right, the playoff run he had. Steph Curry, you know, you saw what he did when KD wasn't there and trying to step his game up. You know, he's the interesting one, in my opinion. I've never seen a guy that's so humble and has such a good heart receive so much hate.
Who's that?
Steph Curry. And it's an amazing thing, but what he's done, what a game of basketball.
Hey!
It's incredible, and he's going to continue to do it.
Not from you guys.
But just in general, you know, you
hate
always see.
But Steph Curry?
Yeah, why do they hate on him?
I think we feel it from guys in the league.
Man, is this a joke? Am I being trolled? Because Andre Iguodala is looking the same way, like, is this a joke? You guys are the ones that are main guys that hate on Steph Curry. Especially you, Max. That's why he gave you that little weird look. Like, are you for real? Max, you're the main one that's been killing Steph Curry. Oh, he can't shot, and he's not clutch, and he doesn't, whenever it counts, he can't make the shot. Whenever it's the fate of the universe or the galaxy of the world, Steph Curry's not going to make that shot, and he doesn't ever come through. He's not an MVP, and all this other type of garbage. And now, Max, you're going to sit there and talk about who hates on Steph Curry? Who's that guy that hates on Steph Curry? Who is we? And he says it with a straight face. And Andre Iguodala is looking around like, these people are sick. You guys have to be sick. So let's continue.
And we feel it in the media. And I think it's, he's carrying a whole shoe brand. You know, he's got his own media company now. He's doing so many great things. And
so it's maybe more jealousy?
I think that's what it is.
But on the other hand, Steph shows, like, Steph's the most popular player with the kids.
Yes.
Like, what Steph shows is that you don't have to be the tallest, you don't have to be the fastest. If you work hard, kids, I mean, it's an illusion because one out of a billion get to be Steph Curry, but you know, he's more their size, baby face.
Right.
He shows if you work hard, you can still be a big deal, right? Like, I mean, in that way, he connects with the youth market maybe more than anybody.
Oh, for sure. I think we feel it more because we're in it every day. So, anytime we, you know, you see Steph walking down the street, I remember one time he left his wedding ring in his laundry bag, and the laundry bag I took. And he walked in the hotel off the bus, and somebody took a picture and said he wasn't wearing his ring. So that's the other side that we see that others may not.
I've had criticism of
every
Steph.
Single day.
Yeah, you have, Max. You criticize Steph a lot. And that's probably what Andre Iguodala was probably about to lead up to until all you guys started acting stupid, like they don't know who's been hating on Steph Curry. And then it seemed like Andre Iguodala kind of wanted to step back like, these people are really weird because you guys are the main ones that are talking trash about Steph every time we lose a game. Even when we win, you guys still talk about trash about Steph and us. So, I don't know. This is weird. This is really weird. So, I don't know. Keep going.
I've had criticism of Steph. No one's above criticism. Our job is just to look and say what
we
see.
Yes.
This series, I saw positive signs in the finals when you needed him most. No Clay, 47 points. Can you hit the big shots in game five? Yes, repeatedly, when you needed him most. But that's the first time I've seen him do that in the finals. And we've had a recurring argument on this show, which I suspect Andre will be against me on this one, but we'll see. My claim is this. Open shot. Not go get your shot. Open shot. Fate of the universe on the line. We have it?
Are we doing this
Clay.
Now?
Okay.
With the game on the line, one shot, who would you rather have taking it, Iggy or Curry?
Of everyone on Golden State, open shot, fate of the universe on the line or the Martians have the death beam pointed at Earth, you better hit it. I want Iguodala. Iguodala's got ice water in his veins. Iguodala is that type of player. High leverage moment, fate of the universe on the line. I want open shot, not go get it. I want Iguodala taking that shot for me. So you're not the
So first off, Max, you've got to be sick to say that. You got to be sick. Open shot, uncontested, an open shot between Iguodala or Steph Curry, arguably the best shooter ever. Open shot? I mean, you got to be kidding me. Why don't we jump the stakes up a little bit, Max? I'll put it to you like this. Let's jump up the stakes. Let's put your family's life on the line, okay? It's life or death with your family. Who do you want to hit this shot? Iguodala or do you want Steph Curry? Open shot, like you said. Open shot. Not to fake the universe. We're going to go with your family. You and your family, life on the line. And you make the shot, you live, you miss it, you die. Which one do you want to shoot an open shot? Steph Curry or Andre Iguodala? Let's keep it real. So let's keep going.
Shooter Steph is, but I'm saying when it matters most, you're the dude I think doesn't care about that moment. Same guy, like ice water in his veins. Your response?
He crazy. if you can, it's the best shooter of all time. Off the dribble, at his position, I say he's the second best point guard of all time. If you argue Isaiah Thomas is better than him, I won't fight. But in my opinion, second best point guard of all time behind Magic Johnson, one of the best shooters of all time, probably the best shooter of all time, putting the ball in his hands.
Then why doesn't he hit that shot at the end of the games more consistently in the finals? I know he's the best shooter of all time. I agree with that. I'm talking about when the moment, the leverage moment, is at its highest. Like, you see hit what that doing? Shot more
see
often.
What you're doing right there? See what you're doing right there? You acting like he didn't hit it. Here's what he's doing, Andre. He's acting like you did not understand his question because you disagree with him. No, Max, he comprehended exactly what you said.
I'm not asking
he, like
question.
Everybody else on the planet, disagreed. No, you said, no. You
no,
came back and you said,
question.
Like, fate of the universe.
No, no,
fate
no,
of the
no,
universe,
no, no. What
fate
I said
the universe.
Was, what I said was, why no hasn't moment. He hit that shot more often since he is the greatest shooter of all time? In fact,
he missed.
It would maybe be in a game 7 if he hits the shot at the end of game 6.
I mean, if you look at it, how many bodies were thrown at him every time he got the ball? I mean, that's the reason why I'm open. So I don't even have the opportunity to show you that I could make the shot if it's not for him. So, you know.
Thank you, Andre, because that makes the perfect sense. And it's almost like Max, either he ignores or doesn't know or doesn't understand or doesn't care about double teams and triple teams. When it comes down to the wire, comes down to the last seconds, you're going to put all your players on the best shooter on the squad, and that's going to leave other people be open. Who would you rather leave open, Iguodala or Steph Curry? I wouldn't even want to go one-on-one with Steph Curry. I easily double-team Steph Curry and make everybody else make their shot because that's how much respect and how good Steph Curry is. That's what I'm saying. I don't think Max understands what a double-team or triple-team is. There's a reason that we just saw in a video like a minute and a half ago, Andre Iguodala took that shot and he was wide open. He was wide open. Rewind back and go back about a minute. You will see Andre Iguodala takes that shot. He is wide open. There's nobody around him for like 10 feet easily. That's why he gets those type of shots. I don't think Max understands that. And he doesn't understand it. He doesn't care or whatever. But it just doesn't make sense. But I guarantee you, the life on the line of him and his family, and you want to have an open shot with Steph Curry and Iguodala, I bet you he probably goes with Curry. I bet you. But let's keep going.
He had three guys on him at half court in that possession, and then he threw a pass to Sean. Sean makes an incredible pass to me. I'm wide open. But even that last shot in game 6, you know, they had three guys running at him, and he's coming off full speed shooting three. I mean, how many guys can even get that shot off? So he's going to continue to have opportunities. He's going to knock him down.
Dre, Max has already been told this. I'm glad you echoed the sentiment. Thank God somebody else did. I will tell you this, though. Klay Thompson, we got Steph Curry. I think an argument could be made that Klay Thompson easily is top 5 shooter of all time, arguably number 2 ever, because to me, he shoots that well. Tell me whether or not you agree with that. And point number 2, are you worried about Klay at all in terms of getting back healthy?
I definitely agree with Klay being one of the top shooters of all time. Just watching those two guys shoot is just, when they retire, they'll just do shooting clinics for the rest of their lives. And be millionaires. That's how good shooters they are. As far as his injury, he's a tough guy. If you notice, he hasn't missed many games at all. He's had broken fingers, he's twisted ankles, and he's played through all types of things. His hamstring was strained. He probably shouldn't have been back. Most guys wouldn't have been back. Not to say he should have been back, but most guys wouldn't have came back in the finals the way he was able to and still give us big numbers. But we have a great training staff. My guy Rick, I call him Ric Flair. He's the ACL specialist. So he'll have him ready. He'll be even better than he was before, so I'm really confident in that. And Kevin, too, I really feel like he'll get back to the Kevin Durant that we all seen this